The Huawei P10 second generation dual Leica cameras are one of its defining features, and yet they're completely absent from the simpler P10 Lite. So does a set of simpler snappers undermine the otherwise solid mid-ranger that this phone is, or can he still snap happy? Versus the full-fat P10, this Lite version sports a single 12 megapixel primary sensor with an f2.2 aperture and 1.25 micron pixels, paired with a single LED flash, whilst an 8 megapixel autofocus effort with an f2.0 aperture sits on the front. Fire up the camera app and the experience on offer is a nice evolution of Huawei's long-standing interface design. The main viewfinder isn't too busy, with some 13 modes just a swipe to the right and relevant camera settings always accessible by swiping left. You can download more from the mode selection screen and edit their order by tapping the pencil icon in the corner, making the experience wholly personalizable to your tastes and needs. Some of the more unique native offerings that you'll seldom find outside of Huawei's handsets include Pro Video Mode, Watermark, and All Focus, which lets you refocus shots after capture. But there are also more conventional but nonetheless useful inclusions like manual control and HDR shooting as well. Tapping the mode name near the shutter will revert you back to the standard still capture too, so no matter where you are within the camera's experience, it's easy to jump back to simple snapping without having to swipe around first. Beauty mode can be applied to subjects using either the front or back cameras, along with real-time filters that make your shots Instagram ready in an instant. Huawei has also tried to make the methods of capture as easy as possible, with a voice-activated shutter option that lets you take a photo by saying cheese or a hearty fusro da. There's also the option of touch capture, so you can tap anywhere within the viewfinder to take a picture, and ultra snapshot, which lets you snap a photo from sleep by double-tapping the volume down key. It even gives you a sleep to snap time just to show off. Essentially, the ways in which you can take a photo on the P10 Lite are many and varied, and we appreciate that. Shots typically appear accurately coloured and well exposed, with a pleasing amount of dynamic range on display, even if the resultant images look a little subdued as a result. Throwing HDR mode in on top of an already bright, well exposed image doesn't appear to make all that much of a difference, however. Despite what seems like a relatively narrow aperture and the phone's small sensor size, the main camera's low light performance is actually commendable, with low noise and only moderate grain. Detail will take a hit when shooting handheld, whilst the flash does a good job of exposing subjects in a pleasing enough manner, even if the single LED arrangement is a little too narrow when firing off. As for the more exotic features on offer, light painting in particular can be used to great effect, whilst the beauty mode actually works right through the scale, with higher settings undoubtedly looking a little heavy-handed but not turning you into an extraterrestrial as some others do. The 8-megapixel selfie machine also offers a well-rounded experience. Colour depth and detail is certainly lacking compared to the Lite's main camera, but the overall result is still pleasant, especially with such a competent beauty mode and effective screen-based flash on hand. This mid-range P10 loses out on its flagship sibling's 4K video recording, so footage tops out at full HD at 30 frames per second. Pro Video Mode lets you tweak exposure, white balance, and focus method, whilst object tracking is the only other obvious option when you dive into the settings menu. The best attribute of the P10 Lite's video recording is its autofocus. It's just so damn fast. The phone seemed perfectly comfortable as I swung in close on a metal sign before quickly panning back to a wide shot, and all the while, it kept everything looking clear. Actual image quality appears to suffer when shooting in higher contrast environments, underexposing darker areas, whilst no apparent stabilization tech seems like a significant shortcoming as well. Audio meanwhile is clear and wind noise is handled well, but the microphones also pick up plenty of background din and struggle to create clear stereo separation. Don't pick up the P10 Lite expecting the same top-tier camera experience as its flagship brethren, but at the same time, don't let the branding fool you. Whilst this handset might be light on cameras, it's certainly got ability where it counts. Hopefully you enjoyed this, our Huawei P10 Lite camera review, and don't forget you can also check out the full review and a tips and tricks video on Recombi.com's YouTube channel. Don't forget to subscribe, check out the website, and thanks for watching.